Thank God it's Friday. Welcome to Celebrity Friday on Your View. I am Mariah Afolabi Brown. As always, I have my lovely co-host here. Hello, ladies.
Hello, Mariah.
Looking all nice. You guys look like the same, like lollipops.
Hello.
And yellow. How are you doing, YK?
Hello, Mariah. I'm not wearing yellow, though.
But it looks lemon. Like yellow.
Yes, lemon. It's in the same family. But.
So, guys, everything is yellow.
Is it we should not wear red? Red makes us angry.
Yes.
You know.
It makes you angry, your emotions. So you're wearing yellow today.
So today I decided to fly the yellow color since, and I think it's working. Because a lot of people say, why are you smiling today?
Smiling and giggling. It's the color. Say, look at.
I'm smiling today, so I'm happy.
I spent the night killing mosquitoes because there wasn't power overnight. Ex-Governor Fashola was still waiting for you. We know that they have not given him his budget yet because it hasn't been passed. But I'm happy that I'm on the show with YK and Uwa today because YK called me out yesterday about the security situation. And as much as three of us have witnessed Amdrobi in traffic, we can't actually say we know what Uwa went through because each situation is different. But the case is that as far as everybody who goes through that process does not report it, you can't hold the police accountable. They need data. Maybe you were attacked on Friday because somebody who was attacked on Thursday did not report it. Maybe somebody else was attacked on Saturday because you did not report your own. They're not magicians and they need our help. When you were attacked, you needed to go to the police. And she was using the case of that I have gone to the police before. That was a financial crime that you needed them to pursue. It's different from armed robbery. They need to know on a daily basis.
Can I just say something?
Mm-hmm.
Uwa said they drove her all the way from Western Avenue by the stadium all the way to Oronsoke, Bariga. They didn't meet one of those.
I heard you yesterday. I heard her yesterday. What she's driving at is to say there wasn't any police.
Somebody is watching for the first time. Let her finish.
Okay.
They didn't meet any vehicle. One, they took them to the bank. There was nobody inside. No security agent inside.
Now,
do you know where Western Avenue is? They drove all down Ikorodu Road, down Oronsoke.
So we're both right.
No. The point I want to drive out of this is that. When Governor Ambode came into office, like 90% of Lagosians were complaining. Morning and night, we're being attacked in traffic. He's not the commissioner of police. It is Nigerian police force, not Lagos police force. But he thought to himself, rather than use our money to do road, let's supply the Lagos police force with equipment to take care of Lagosians. It's paramount. Now, if that has reduced from 90% to 50%, for instance, and the 50% are not telling the police because they think that these people won't do anything, if they don't know what is going on, they're not on Twitter. If they don't know what is going on, for instance, if they think that
what Lagos do you mean by not on Twitter?
Can I talk?
Because I can Google Nigerian police force on Twitter for you now.
Okay.
When the campaign was going on, it was through Twitter and social media. A lot of things happened. But let me leave that case. This morning, I wanted to come out. It's part of the case.
I wanted to come out this morning.
Yes. 6 a.m. I started hearing gunshots. So I just saw free sit down for my house. Okay. But you see, the truth is that, you see, I hear you. And I will report it. But you see, it's not just enough to report. The fact that we have a platform and I'm talking about it is enough. Ground.
Hold on, let me finish.
I allowed you to talk, madam.
I'm answering you.
The cars that you're talking about, these new cars that Governor Ambode gave to this police. If you go on Lekki Road from VI to Lekki all the way to Ajah, you will see more than 5-6 of that.
Unfortunately,
no, I'm saying, Ryan, listen. How possible is it? All the way, you can't even find one inside.
Honestly,
hang in there.
Wait, let me say. I think both parties.
Let me explain.
I don't want you to because I don't want us to focus on it. It's not our focus.
We'll make it a hot topic.
But we'll make it a hot topic another day. But I think both of you are right. You're right to say that every case must be reported. You are saying, listen, even though I will report it,
doesn't make any difference.
Throughout that entire night, I didn't see any RS vehicle. Maybe I would have been felt safer.
It makes a difference. My friend was attacked yesterday night, leaving Okwebi, and right at Salvation, he called 911.
He said
his
friend was attacked. Oh.
Yes, he did.
And she said security has improved.
I didn't say it has stopped. The police came there yesterday night as he called 911.
911, okay.
Yes, 911 now works in Lagos. You don't have information. Don't come and just come and
which
say that.
Which way 911?
No, I'm just saying.
What they
no,
did they call 911? Their phones were carried.
911, they just started it.
How did they call 911?
Let's take a quick break. 911.
Which phone, no?
Let's not turn this to our hot topic for today. Let's take a break. We'll be right back. The punch. Economic crisis. Buhari hits Soyinka's advice. OK's conference. Picture here of Adamawa explosion kills 4 policemen. Alleged 1 trillion naira diversion. Senate plans to arrest Lamode. Annex slate Edo Ondo governor polls for September and November. Jonathan's ex-ADC detained on Army's directive, says EFCC. EFCC to invite Obanikoro Mwazu over car gifts. Benue killings getting out of hand, says governor. Fresh fuel crisis looms over dollar shortage, and one dies as Ladipo traders clash with soldiers. Okay, we're talking about which one?
The picture for what's it called now?
Yeah, the Adamawa explosion.
Yeah, the explosion in Adamawa. According to a report I read, I read it from which paper now? They said that the police had apprehended
the bombs
from the Boko Haram, and the bombs exploded. And because this police station is located within, there's a school there. I think what else is there? It's within town, the police station. Mm. So a lot of people, you know, were injured. Yeah. About 80 people or so were conveyed to the hospital. Then 4 policemen died. And people were saying that the bombs were planted, but the police is insisting that it wasn't planted, that they actually confiscated those bombs. Mm. So the point I'm trying to raise in this story, when I read it, I was saying that, is it possible that when they apprehend bombs like that, you know, instead of taking it to the regular police station, probably take it somewhere, the outskirts.
No, even you before know? That, when you apprehend the bomb, when you...
You're supposed to check it if it's live,
to detonate
right?
it yeah. first. You can't leave a live bomb. It's going to go off.
Do you
now.
Understand? Wait, did the bomb go off with
it
them?
Went off. It went off.
Yes, the bomb
it had
went
been
off.
There for some time. Yeah. And so the bomb said, ah, I'm
that's
tired.
What I'm saying. No, that's what I'm saying, YK.
You have to detonate
but
it.
But the bomb, at least taking it to... For instance, I think the government right now, based on this incident that has happened, go and station somewhere.
There should even be an special
outside,
bomb
yes,
where
you need that is outside of town.
You can actually submit this.
So even if it explodes, nobody is dying, you know?
It can't even, if you detonate it, it will not explode now.
So I was going to say Boko Haram came.
No! That's a story.
That's what they are saying.
That's
what they are saying, but they are even implicating themselves more. Mm. Because how can you carry a bomb, a live bomb, and put it down and say, oh, hello, bomb, I'm looking at you. Of course, it's going to go off now.
All right, let's.
I was going to take Buhari's.
We'll talk about Buhari. I think it's in a other paper. I want to talk to the Ladipo story. I don't think it's in
the other. It's in other papers, but the Ladipo story also. They said there's a thug, one popular guy. His name is Mr. Mondi. He's really
Mondi Jora. He comes to tax them.
Really
so the tax collector.
He comes with touts. He comes to harass them in Ladipo. I think something happened and somebody died. So the shop owners in Ladipo, they shut down the shops and they went on the streets. They were really, really upset, protesting the death of one of them. So,
okay. Moving on very quickly to The Nation. Refund 310 million naira for 23 cars. EFCC tells Uche Secondus. Troops rout Boko Haram fighters in multiple clashes. Sunday Olise quits as Eagles coach. Edo governorship poll for September 10th on Do November 26th. Okay. Which one are you talking about?
Olise.
He has quit.
Is it that story?
Said, I read the story is that he has quit. He says he's sick.
No, he said no. that he's
constant illness.
Constant illness.
That's just one of it.
There are family members, but he said something that had to do with a breach of contract.
Yeah, so not they're sure. not paying. They're not paying his staff and the players and himself the agreed contract amount, which is a Nigerian thing. But then again, I didn't think that Sunday Olise was going to last so much.
But Secondus, he says he wants to return the 23 cars. Not the EFCC money. Have said, no, give us the money. It's not the 23 cars. Give us the money.
Let somebody sell it now.
So I calculated it that each car 13 million. 13 point something million.
Depreciated by now, so...
So the car doesn't have value. So they rather collect
that's
the
why
money.
They want the money because the cars have depreciated.
But is it fair?
You know when you buy a brand new car.
I mean,
when you buy a brand new car, so you are driving it out of the showroom. 500k out already.
I know,
so the
but
they are focusing on the cash.
Where would he get the money from?
You should first of all sell the 23 cars. Then probably look for some 2-3 properties. It will make it up now.
Beg, EFC should have mercy. Okay, moving on.
Why is it your relation?
No, I'm just saying now. How can I steal 310 million? I buy cash. Not time to give you. Like I don't want to steal my money. Who will steal?
They say that 10-year jail term or he brings 310.
He will bring out the money.
Once he finds the money,
the money will come out.
Daily Sun, $2 trillion asset scam. Senate orders ex EFCC boss arrest. NAFDAC bans beans importation. NUC ranks UI, Unilag, Uniben tops. University listing, reps stop FRSC on speed limits device. Latikpo market boils as traders go on rampage. Reverend King, 0R. Supreme Court decides fate of pastor earlier found guilty of murder by the appeal court. That's today. And 4 killed in police headquarters explosion in Adamawa. What story?
Reverend King.
Want to go with King?
Yeah, Reverend King, whose case has been on forever, and the Court of Appeal, you know, sentenced to death.
Yeah.
By hanging.
He went to the Supreme Court and his case is going to be decided today. He's the first Nigerian pastor to have been condemned to death by any Nigerian court. So we shall be waiting for that story.
He was first put in Lagos. He was first, but all his congregation, they were always going there and disturbing. So they moved him far away, Katsina, where they can't find him.
His people love him. He's their Jesus.
This NAFDAC banning the importation of beans.
Yeah.
I read that story and wow. It really saddens me that we are importing beans in this country. There are so many things that that we shouldn't be doing.
I found that yesterday.
But they said that what they're saying is they would screen. If it doesn't meet up to a specific standard, they will not allow it to come into the country.
Someone was telling me yesterday that they actually import tomato seeds.
Yes.
Because they have these really nice, robust-looking tomatoes. And the ones that are naturally where we grow here are not as sweet and robust as those.
As them. We have a tomato plantation.
So you bought your own
plantation.
Seeds?
We brought in the seedlings. I'm not sure. I think it was from Jos. We brought in the seedlings from. So it's true. But you see, the truth is that if you go to Jos, the kinds of tomatoes you see there are totally different. And they have very good beans in all those areas. So I'm saying that those things are not even things that you should even... bring to the country through import. Well, although I wanted to brag, madam, that will not let us hear what Unilag. Did you hear your ranking?
If she wanted to brag, it would be that she went to UI.
What's the name of that?
You went to Uniben.
That's your problem.
She went to Delta State something.
That's your problem. She will not say. It's not on the map. But trust me, all the people from there, go and find out all the people that are making big money
from
in this country. They are from that school. We're
okay,
not we not bother.
I think your school doesn't have bed bugs.
We don't.
They are not even on the map, Seth. Is it not schools that are on the map?
I'm excited. They said Unilag is
there. I was surprised that Ifeo was not in the list.
Oh. Yeah, no. Well, if you read through, they did all the ranking.
Okay,
Uniben is number 3, so we're good.
Okay. Unilag, first and most.
I beg, it's not first. It's
Vanguard, please. Multi-million dollar deal. EFCC arrests Diezani's cousin, Amambo. This is property document in Abuja. Picture here of our president performing the lesser Hajj in Mecca. Scores killed in Adamawa police station bomb blast. Speculative trading reverses Naira's 3-day gains. Goodness. 300 die as herdsmen farmers clash in Benue. Jonathan's former ADC held on Army's directive, says EFCC. Padded 2016 budget. Reps invite Emefiele, Udo Udoma, Adeosun, others. And alleged 1 trillion Naira fraud. Senate moves to arrest Lamode, ex-EFCC boss.
Mariah, this is your picture, eh? If I talk about it now, they say, why are you always attacking the president? I remember Jonathan and Orisha Jafo in Israel.
Yeah.
And on this same table, how we're saying, are these people serious at all? Is that what they're supposed to be doing? Can't they pray in Nigeria?
Now it
and
is.
I think they went their own personal funds. I don't think they went to
come down. Say it again.
I don't think they went to the federal government.
Okay, you think you don't think. Yeah, okay, you're not sure.
I'm not you sure. Are you that sure? Our president trying to attack.
He went.
Are you sure?
Excuse me.
He went. Shebi
went on official duty.
God bless you.
Why can't he official? Now he's doing his Hajj.
His hotel now. He'll not be paying for himself. I'm sure he hold is. On, and then he won't be collecting Esther code again. Abi, so. When he said he's going officially for 1 week,
he has gone and he has done the official.
Is his repertoire is to go and also pray. We are the ones paying for that trip.
Are you sure?
Hey, yes,
he's praying for you now. He's praying for all of you.
If it's Jonathan now, they will hold him responsible.
Anyway, meanwhile,
listen. Let our president pray right now.
I saw a train yesterday. I almost fainted.
Which train?
Air conditioned train.
Where?
So I said, ah! So the way I shouted, the person in the car with me said, what is wrong with me? I said, ah, see train. No.
In Nigeria?
Like Bolede. I'm telling you. So he said, didn't I know that Jonathan put 20 of them on the road? I said, me that I was just
there's only one train, no, now then. There's one train. It's the same thing that's going around.
The train I saw was green. The picture he showed me was yellow of trains. That they even
take one train with four coaches. They even, that's what they
Mr. Lukman.
They said that if people even take trains from Alagbole to Ebutebeta.
Alagbole, where is that again?
My area. Okay. You know, you will be. You
don't
see,
mind her.
Don't mind her. She said it's better to be poor than rich.
I need to come to Alagbole.
I said it's better to be poor than rich. But you say Alagbole.
No, I don't know Alagbole now. Like, where is that on the map?
See her mouth.
You also know. This day. I'll go and visit you in Alagbole. When I come there, say, Alagbole in the field. This day, Buhari to go
back. All Alagbole people, they will not be your fans again.
Buhari has loved Saji finally.
What?
Buhari to convene National Economic Conference in March. House, Mark condemned Atagu killings as death toll hit 100. Let's see, in support of women's basketball, that's the picture here from Zenith Bank. Interesting. Few scarcity looms as federal government seeks to swap more oil. Court strikes out its salad suit against MTN over Visa phone acquisition. Right, which story are we taking? Our economic summit?
I want to talk about fuel scarcity.
We always have conferences here and there, but this one seems like a very needed one.
Yes.
In their NEC meeting, National Executive Council meeting in January, the NEC, which consists of federal and state government, came together and said, you know what, we need to call together an emergency economic summit, asking everyone, how do we get out of this economic mess that we're in? And Professor Wole Soyinka had advised the same thing. Mm-hmm. So this summit is supposed to be solution-driven. It's not for us to come and wail. We all know what the problems are. Yeah. What are the solutions? Yeah. This is what we're seeking for in this conference.
Professor Soyinka had actually suggested that they should have all stakeholders, everybody, yes, partisans.
Everybody.
Everybody involved.
You should invite me.
But it's not about paying people monies, 7 billion or 6 million each, you know, like the last national conference that we had. No.
You're talking about the oil fields?
Yeah, they said the fuel scarcity, according to reports I read, they said for a bit now, they've not been able to get new bookings for production and importation of fuel because of the dollar shortage.
So we're swapping.
Then even NNPC also has been unable to sign exchange of crude oil for products. So it's possible that, you know,
there might be a bit of scarcity.
Okay. So I just hope they'll be able to sort it out before time.
Please remind me to buy petrol today.
That's all we can take on Front Page Review. When we return, we discuss celebrity gist. Stay with us, we'll be right back. Welcome back. Nollywood actress Kate Henshaw has reacted to a post on Instagram where a fan insulted her by calling her ugly. But she didn't find it funny. She decided to go on with the fan and insulted the living daylight out of him. Now, we ask, should a celebrity lash back at ugly comments? That's our hot topic for today. You can call us on 070-806-6804. You can tweet to us at TVC Connect, and please hashtag your view TVC so we can read your tweets. All right, who read this thing? Did you read Jumoke? I know Jumoke has read that kind of things.
I read it too.
And everybody is going to know my own response already because I attack. If you attack me, I will attack you. Now, people will say, there's some decorum that you should, as a celebrity, blah, blah, blah. I think that people also use it because I know, for instance, that if I slap a lawyer, he shouldn't do anything because his profession does not allow him. So I go to slap him at the slightest excuse. I don't think he's right.
I think we should first establish the story. What had happened was that Ketensho
posted a picture
of herself, and then this fan said, "Oh, what this ugly woman," and just generally abused her. Now, and she lashed back. I haven't been doing social media. You people are the ones that put me on social media. there was this foolish person. I can't even remember his name, and he was just abusing me, my brother, just abusing my family, my two brothers. And I was like, why? So you know, I started to reply him. I wasn't insulting him, but I was replying him, and he was just going haywire.
Yeah.
And what has happened is that Twitter, Facebook has given
everybody,
people who normally can't see you and talk to you,
yeah,
the power, because they are faceless,
yes,
to just insult you as they want.
Yeah.
So it was now people are saying, please, don't answer him. Just let him go. You are only making him popular. And what was happening was he was getting more followers, and people who didn't know about the matter were just coming in and talking, abusing him, and he was not abusing.
So you're better off ignoring.
So I now just blocked him. And I've learned from experience and age as well that silence is a virtue.
Yes, thank you, YK.
If someone abuses you and just looking at the person as if he's stupid,
the person becomes stupid.
He will be the one upset. You will be weary. So I don't even, me personally, I will not.
Because I know there are some people on Facebook that if you say something to them, oh goodness, they will give it to you hot. Hot, hot, hot.
Can I say?
Yes.
See, I feel that when it comes to responses on social media, you are making the person feel important. That's number one. And you are not sure of who you are. Because if somebody goes out on Twitter to say I am ugly, I look at myself in the mirror. I have a mirror in my house. Do you understand? It would not, I won't even break a sweat when you say I'm ugly. Why? When I look at myself every day in the morning and, you know, I'm like, this is a pretty lady. So what's your problem? I think when you begin to respond
to... So you look at yourself and you say,
Of course.
If you don't like yourself, you like it.
Lizard say, if they don't praise them, ain't go praise himself. Now, it's true. Because you see, the truth is that what you think of yourself, I see it that way. If somebody comes out to say, you're ugly, you're this, you're that, I always look at it, what do I think of myself? If I don't think of myself that way, then I don't see that thing as holding any weight where I am. Because if you start to give those people the time of your day, it will go on and on and on. Now, taking this cue from the day we did the show on, what's it called, on the hijab, that we wore the hijab in to commensurate with the World Hijab Day, somebody just went on my page and they kept, see, you know when they say somebody is deaf and dumb and blind? That was what I played out. But you see, because natural instinct of human beings is that when they just see, because they feel that I have access to you and all that, they will just lash out and they will keep on talking and insulting people. So I don't give you that benefit of, I don't give you my time at all.
Let me take Martha's confession. Martha, are you there?
Means what you're saying is right now.
Martha.
Yeah, confess that.
Martha, are you there?
Yes.
Go ahead, please.
I just wanted to say that I feel as a celebrity, whatever you do, there are people that will talk about it. So the best thing to do is just to keep quiet. Because if you keep responding to them, they'll keep talking and talking. Yes.
Okay.
I feel as a celebrity.
Yeah, we got to.
Whatever you do, people will talk about it. So I think you should just keep quiet about it because
point taken.
You do, they'll keep talking.
All right, thanks, Martha.
Martha to say that regardless of what you do, people will talk, and there'll be some things that you don't even have the time of day, you know, and you're going to move on. But for instance, Tiwa Savage, The first time she put up a picture of her son wearing a monkey suit, somebody went on her page and said, monkey. A 6 months old baby. Why would you do that? You know? So for someone like me, if the only way of expressing the emotion that you have brought up is to attack you back, it doesn't do me any good, but it doesn't do me any harm also. I will give you the response that you need and then move on. Yes, I agree that going back and forth, what I've noticed, YK, that yes, there are some people who want to use you to become popular because the back and forth, other people can see it.
Yes.
And then they start to follow that person. I won't do it in a way that they can follow you. I will give you the response in a way that it's only you that will see it.
So that means you will start to follow the person and you direct message.
I will, for instance, if I tag you, then they see you. If I say it, it's only you who see it. But you know, I'm talking
that is
to
not
you.
Twitter. Everybody sees it now. Mm. If there's a page on Twitter, everybody can. If it's Twitter, and this was Twitter.
Yes.
So in like Ketensha's case, I believe that a lot of her fans took the person up.
Yes. Now
they will fight for you. And well, I'm talking from personal experience. When this thing happened to me, and I was facing the person, a lot of
your fans say, "Well, so leave him.
Please.
Let me handle him for you.
You are too big to be.
Thank you.
Talking to this." Yeah. These rats. Let us face him for you. Mm-hmm. And they were facing him. And the person in the end, I blocked him, so I could only see
their own response.
Their own responses, because I stopped responding. Mm. You know, because I've not realized with age and you know, because of who my father is, we have faced a lot of
attack and all that.
And if they tell me, oh, musicians that have left my brother, we're abusing him, lying. And my brother was getting and I said, look, Femi, don't.
Yeah.
Don't read it. Don't go there. Block them. Mm. It's better because what you don't know cannot hurt you.
Mm-hmm. Let me take this call from Martins. Martins, are you there? I'm sorry for keeping you.
There are a few tweets that Juliet says, silence is not just a virtue. It's the best answer to a fool. Commander-in-Chief says, but we shouldn't forget that celebs are humans too. So it isn't just about being a celeb. They're humans and have emotions. Omolaja said, Kate shouldn't have gone all the way out. She's a role model and a public figure expected to display some level of decorum.
That's what I want to hinge upon, because the truth is that I've had my own share of people going on Facebook or Twitter saying one or two things about me. I read it, but I don't even give them the benefit to think I read it. Mm-hmm. I just totally ignore it. Because I feel that as a role model, a lot of people are looking at you and you're judged by the way you handle things, the way you handle issues. So I try really hard to just act as if I never saw it. And for me, that has worked for me much better.
Because it makes them more angry. Do you know that?
When they've
gone all out to use all the energy, me, sometimes I truly don't even read it. But sometimes, even when I see it, I pretend like I don't see it. And I just move on. Because you see,
they will know I saw it because I will block you. So you can never contact me in your life again. Block it.
Yes, we have more tweets. Salami says, I support what Yeni Kuti said. If the celeb had ignored the fan, it wouldn't have been a hot topic today. Remember, the goal is cheap publicity.
Aha.
Fatima says, good morning to you all. Sister Yemi, as you has said it all, because silence is the best answer for a fool.
Sure.
Don Ike says, I love this phrase while growing up. Silence is the best answer for a fool.
Okay.
And Zach, the last one, says, the best response to anyone that insults you is to ignore and pray to God for patience to do that, because it's not easy.
It's not easy. Thank you. That is what I wanted to hinge upon. Yeah. It is not easy. Easy, because when somebody, we are all human now, and someone, for no reason, you just come and abuse and you will get angry, but you just have to restrain.
During
this,
all right, we need to take a quick commercial break. Unfortunately, we can't go ahead. I hope our celebrity guest is in house, because we have to take a break now. We'll be right back. Welcome to the show again. Taya Odoike, popularly known as Sikiratu Sindodo.
is a Yoruba actress who is a graduate, and the beautiful actress has featured in over 50 movies and remains one of the most sought-after actresses in Yoruba Nollywood because of her abilities to switch in between different roles with ease and professionalism. With the Yobi, welcome. Let's give a clap. Sirikat, how are you doing?
I'm fine, thank you.
You prefer to be called Sirikat or?
Sikirat. But my name is Tayo.
How are you doing, Tayo? Sorry about the traffic. I know you had to rush down here.
I'm telling you.
Thank you. Tayo. From Sikrat is a Muslim
stage name.
Did you change from Islam to Christianity or something?
No, I'm a Muslim. I'm still a Muslim. Okay, my name is Tayo Dueke. I featured in a movie called Sikirat Osinodo.
Okay.
And that was actually the movie that brought
me to my name. So the name
stuck. Yes.
Just like Jennifer.
Yes,
okay.
That's fantastic.
Happy belated birthday. It was your birthday last week, yes?
Yes, thank you.
Congratulations. We saw the pictures online. So you're an Alaja, right? We see all the gold, silver. Yes, how is that about? What happens when you go to Maka? They just start getting teeth or what? I always see people come back with their gold.
I went to pray now.
Yes. And we know.
And it was like 6 years, 6 years ago.
So what's the significance of the gold tooth or the silver tooth?
Actually, back then
did I touch a nerve?
I did it because of a reason. It was not because I really wanted it, but I had to do it because of someone then.
Aww. Okay, let us go to your, let's go to acting, because I see that you're a little emotional. You have acted over 50 Yoruba movies. Yes?
Over 100.
Wow. Fantastic. So how did you get into the movie industry?
I got into the industry in 1999.
Okay.
It was actually when I was seeking admission into university then. I think I was home and a friend of mine just came to the house and said that, oh, Tayo, they're having one audition at Adeniyi Ogunsanya at Charles Novia's office. So I think it was Don Pedro Obaseki's movie then. You know, they now gave me a role of a bodyguard.
Wow.
I was very tiny. And I was supposed to do Sheikh Marinzi's bodyguard. So I was right behind him with a gun and all that. So when we left set, I was not talking to Sheikh. I was not like, oh, there's this movie you're supposed to go and do. When he actually knew I was Yoruba, he now said I should meet Yinka Fora.
Okay.
She's a Yoruba producer. So when I met her, she said, oh, that she was going to give me one particular role. It was a party scene, and I started from there, and I started getting jobs, and, you know, and Sikirat Osinodo's job just came like that, and that was how I...
Now, you haven't been without controversy since you started the movie.
Too many.
Lots. This one new. That one new. And you cannot come to a show where we have women.
I will
ask you. Give us a procursion.
We need to get some juice.
Well, me, I'm ignorant. I don't know when you come to this.
That's, so, Jumoke, can help me? Yes.
Do you want to talk about MC Oluomo?
Actually, when they called me that I had to come on this program, I was like,
these women.
I said, okay, I'll come. But before I got on set with you, I was going to tell you guys that I didn't want to go to that area.
Okay.
You know, but I came in a rush and we couldn't even talk. But yes, I dated him and we broke up. You know, there are some circumstances in this life that just happens that you don't expect. You know, and when the controversy was everywhere, I didn't expect it was going to be that much, but it got to me at a stage, but I'm over it now.
Yeah. We thank God.
Before you came, because it's sad that you couldn't catch up with what we talked about before you came. We're talking about responding to hateful comments from fans. So how do you deal? Yeah, you know, Ketensha went all out at the fan that called her ugly and all that. She went at him and all that, and she was giving it back to him. So how do you deal with, you know, hateful comments, negative comments? Do you just block them off or do you respond to them? How do you deal with them?
As at that time, like 6 years, the social media thing was not
as popular
as this. So I wouldn't have known what I would have done back then. But now, the worst thing they told me back then was maybe I was an educated prostitute, you know. But if they had told me that now, I would just have block them on my page, and but I think the tension is down, you know, so they can say shit, they can say so many things, and it doesn't get to me because
I've developed a thick skin, as in too many years in the industry. Yes. They've called you all the worst names.
Yes.
What are they going to call me again? You want to keep me already?
Yes. You know? So most like some few years back, I was always in the front page of all the magazines. They were always like throwing different things at me, and it got to me at a stage. Yeah. I used to cry and all that. But later,
let me tell you what my father always used to say. Any publicity is good publicity. Mm. Because you are important, they are putting you. So I'm just advising you, don't even let it get to you. If they put you anything, they say, okay. Because you are important to whoever is writing really? Rubbish.
Yes, yeah.
That is why they are writing about you.
On the other flips, on the flip side, we are women, we go through issues. Mm. People make mistakes, and it's okay to make mistakes. Mm. And we're not gonna sweep the issues on the carpet like, oh, it didn't happen. But what is important is that there are people looking up to you, that young people that get into the industry and you, and they're going to face the things you faced. Mm-hmm. So it's key that we don't just gist about it, but you also tell us the learnings. That, okay, what do you do? What would you do differently?
Yeah.
What you learn from these experiences as a celebrity, how the fans took it. For young people who are actually getting into the industry, what advice would you give to them concerning the issues that you've been through?
You see, most of the people coming into the industry now, they just want to come and like
be popular,
they won't have the fame. Because at that time back then, when I got into the industry, I wanted to prove a point to the people around me, the likes of Fete Abalogun, the likes of Buki Wright. I wanted to impress them. I wanted them to know that I could do it. But now the people coming into the industry just want to be popular, they want to have the fame and all that, you know. So even if I advise them on what to do, there are some people that are ready to learn. But some people are not ready. Do you understand? They should look before they leap. Because as at that time, I made some mistakes that I won't make now.
You have learned from experience.
Yes.
In the angle of relationships with producers and all that, because I know a few actors, young girls who want to get into the industry, and I've been asked, oh, you have to sleep with this person, you have to do that. In those kind of cases, what would you
do? I never went through that. They won't force you to date them.
It's your choice.
It's your choice, yes. If they ask you out and you feel, oh, okay, I can date this person, is my taste or something like that, or you want to date him because you want to get a role, you can do it. But I didn't do it. I before I played the role of Secret Sindodo, the producer watched a movie that I did, and he said he actually watched just one scene in that movie. And he called me and said, oh, Tayo, there's this script I want to give you. I never met him. I didn't know him. And he gave me the script to just, I read through it. He said, can you do it? I said, oh, being an actress is to play any role. I can play any character. I can, you know. And I said, okay. But when I got on that set, it was very difficult for me. I could not get into that character. I didn't know what was happening to me. I saw all these celebrities, like all the faces I used to watch back home then, you know. I'm like, okay. And the director was like, where did they bring this girl? Like, I'm not feeling her. I can't work with her. You know, the likes of Lekpa Shandi and Titoyin Adegbola, Ogogo, all of them were on set. You know, Ogo now said to me that, Tayo, calm down. You know, then I had pimples. I was stressed up. Just on one thing. I didn't know what I was doing. He now told me that, okay, just calm down. Go and take your bath, you know, and come back outside. So when I went into my room, I took a shower. I was now nude like this. I was naked. And I started praying. Like, I should just be able to get into that character. And when I prayed, I went out. The first thing that I shot, it was like a miracle. It was on the highway. People were just like, ah, who is this girl? They were, you know, they were clapping and hailing and all that. And that was it.
Yeah, fantastic. Fantastic.
Yeah, it works.
Fantastic.
Yeah. Right. Let's take a quick commercial break. When we come back, more with our celebrity guests. Stay with us. We'll be right back. Come back. Yes, Uwe, you're going to
I was going to first thank you because I know you came through the heavy CMD traffic and you had to take a marwa here. So thank you very, very much for coming. But I wanted to ask, I'm curious about your tooth. Can you remove it or is there for life?
It's there for life.
So yeah. That experience, you're stuck with it because you keep remembering. Yes. Anytime you open your tooth, oh, yikes.
Yes. So they don't coat the tooth. They remove the tooth and put the gold tooth.
No, they didn't.
How do they do it? I'm just curious.
They filed my tooth to be able to put the tooth in there.
Okay.
That's amazing. There's a lot of bling going on there. I want to find out from you how you decided to stick with Yoruba, because you said you used to do English movies back in the day. So what made you choose? Because I know a lot of people in the Yoruba wood, they mix and match roles and all that. So why did you choose and why did you stick to?
Because back then, the jobs were just coming on and on and on at that particular place. Mm. Do you understand? That was why I was stuck.
Oh, okay. So if you have an opportunity to do English movies, yes, it's not like you're going to turn it down.
Let me take a clip for one of your the popular movie that you did.
Okay. Let's see this. Bawo, mo wa wa o ti so kun fe ri e ti pe ti ko ni but ohun oni boldness ati wa buy so mo wa ni pe kin wa be kin wa pe e fun eh ta ni yen ma je kin so eni na fe but ti ma ti pe le wa me ti mo se n to mo bi owo ni gan se
eh o ya lo pe
kin lo ku wa
e se ja e
kilo ti lu baba mi fun are
o ma binu oju ma nti mi ni se gbojo ma binu
anyway wo la ri gbo bayi
sikira lati gba ta ti wa ni ile iwe yen lo ti ma wu mi gege bi omo pin sugbon mi o mo bi mo se ma ko enu fe si eni oju ma nti mi ati pe mo n laya pupo wo mo fe ma mo ni fe re ni se gbojo mo fe ka ma fi pa fun ra wa
mo darun laye mi o fe ma fi mi pa eyin mo kun si nkan te ni ri gas fo bi rara o ko kese lese o mu aba mi o fe ma fi mi pa iru e o fe ma fi emi pa iwo mo do gbalagba to ito ye ko to ye lo o ya wo e sa iru e se mi
ti won pe head boy lo ba so sa
head boy ka lo fi head boy no se to yo head boy lo so wan bo mi so wan ba mi o ti won se la wo je ki so fun e la yi e ba se to school school yi to ba so aba mi to ba so aba mi to fi emi ba mi so wallahi wa
just because I saw a dark actress in that movie, there's this controversial thing about Yoruba actresses never being dark complexion.
Yellow.
Is it the directors who say, elati pupa, if not, the camera will not work with you? What's going on?
Actually, I feel I was like you now.
Mm.
You know. I didn't actually know what happened. The directors don't tell you what to do.
Mm.
You know.
Is it used to be as dark as Jumaka, is that what you're saying?
No, I wish I was like her.
Mm. You know. So is it the influence of other actresses, like, bye, no, she ain't she old tire for you to survive in this industry?
Maybe it's what I see.
Let me take this call from Laja Martins. Laja Martins, are you there?
Yes, I am.
Yes, go ahead, please.
Good morning.
Morning.
I just want to contribute to the celebrity attack you were discussing this morning. I think we should realize that one of the prizes of being a celebrity is insult, celebration. That's what makes you a celebrity. You should be able to absorb. Your shock absorber must be super. As soon as you are growing as celebrities, you must try and build up your shock absorbers.
Can I ask you a question?
Being a celebrity is...
Can I ask you a question, please?
Yes, ask me.
Please, how do you get that shock absorber? You know, if my shock absorber of my car is bad, I will go to the company. As a human being, please, how will I get that shock absorber?
Let me tell you the shock absorber. another.
Now it tries.
Another is, with this position of being a celebrity, you make some money, you make some fame, you make a lot of contacts. People like to meet you.
So that is,
and that is, okay, that is what makes you, gives you that satisfaction. And
thank you so much, Laja Martins. You're right, because we have
just... I haven't got the secret of the shock absorber.
Oh, why can't the shock absorber matter? The role you played in that, this, you seem so gentle, you know? So how are you able to...
She's a good actress. You know? Is what she's,
no, because she's not like that.
That's her role.
I'm saying that it's not... Is this how you are, really? Or
I'm a very calm person.
Really?
Mm. Did you not hear her just say that she had to go and pray to enter to
her? Thinking of her matter.
So what do you do? What do you do to have fun? Just yeah. So because we see you looking very calm.
How, you're so
how
calm.
How do you have fun? Do you go partying? How do, what do you do?
I go to parties, necessary parties. Mm. I'm always home. I'm a home person.
Really?
Yes. That's me.
How far are we relationship front now? What's happening?
Have you seen anyone now?
Oh, I yes, though.
Hey! That's why I can't change yesterday. See how it's just moving left and right? And I said, yeah, okay. Your body was shaking yesterday. So, how is your guy doing? How is he doing?
School.
Hey,
just see how it is that is pressing.
Hey, YK, Jehovah.
Yeah, it's full of enjoyment in our body.
YK. Okay, keep
quiet.
Don't mind her, please. We are religious people here. We don't know what she's talking about.
There's also the controversial issue about smoking and Yoruba actresses. Do you have anything to say about that?
Is their life?
Okay.
Because when... Because I've seen a pack of a cigarette before. Mm. That they write... Smokers are liable to die young. Mm-hmm. And when you see that, and you smoke, it means you want to die.
Well, thank you very much. I was just telling Uwa this morning that in America, they will smoke. When they have cancer, they will now carry themselves the company. To the cigarette company and go and sue the company. And the judge has never asked their question. Uncle,
did you not read the paper?
Yes.
All right. How is your daughter doing?
She's fine.
How old is she? How old is she?
She was 18 last year.
Oh my goodness!
You have an 18-year-old daughter.
Amazing. Oh, wow. So she's in the university now.
Oh,
amazing.
You've been there for a while though.
I'm sure you guys will just be like sisters, you know, yes. When you walk.
Oh, yeah. As we round off, what should we expect from you? What should your fans expect from you? Any word for your fans as we round off?
I just shot a new movie, okay. And I'm shooting another one very soon.
Okay.
So they should just keep their fingers crossed. I know my movies are always very fantastic. That's if you watch it, if you're a fan of
Sikiratu Sinundo.
Then I want to say a very big thank you to my fans who always been there.
Okay.
You know, keep praying for me. I appreciate you. I love you. Thank you so
much. To attack you.
Is your movie going to be in the cinemas?
Yes.
Oh, fantastic. Right. So we're
going. Like on your bling. Excuse me, your shoes.
Hey, my shoe is Jimmy Choo now.
Oh, wow.
You see, she got a tattoo going on.
You sure you got an 18-year-old daughter? Goodness me.
And she's all right. Quiet.
Silence. That's all we can take. Have a lovely weekend. See you Monday. Bye-bye.
Bye.